If you're looking to discover new free software and increase the usability of your computer, then you need to watch this video, because in this video, I'll be covering 5 free programs you might not have heard of before. Plus, I'll be taking you through most of their functions and features. If that sounds interesting to you, be sure to stick around and let's get started. First up, we have Hybrid Uninstaller, which is a highly effective program capable of uninstalling stubborn software, Windows applications, and browser extensions. It also provides various other features that you can use to boost your computer's performance, which we'll touch on a little later. Using a third-party program like Hybrid Uninstaller has several advantages over the default uninstall function in Windows. By using Hybrid Uninstaller, you can easily uninstall software from your PC, even if it has become corrupted and cannot be removed using the default uninstall functions. This can save you time by ensuring that all unused and unnecessary software is removed from your system without spending time diagnosing any errors. Hybrid Uninstaller offers both an installable and portable version. I'll be using the portable version in this video. The primary function of Hybrid Uninstaller is to uninstall programs. On the main screen, I can see all of the installed programs in the form of a list and choose which ones to uninstall. I'll right-click on the program I want to uninstall, and now I can choose to do a normal uninstall or a force removal. I'll click on force removal so I encounter as little resistance as possible. Next, I'll tick the boxes automatically clean up and advanced scan. Once that's done, I'll click on scan. After the initial removal, it'll show a list of leftover files, folders, and registry entries. I'll click on finish to finalize the process. Now, let's take a look at some of the other features of Hybrid Uninstaller. For starters, it has a Windows Store Apps Manager. Here you can debloat your system by uninstalling any unwanted Windows apps. It also has a browser extension manager, where you can view and uninstall browser extensions. The next two features are definitely my favorites, the registry and junk file cleaners. They are both really straightforward to use. You do a scan and then you clean. The junk file cleaner has an advanced mode, but for most users, the common cleaner should be all that's needed. The next feature to check out is the Startup Manager, which includes a virus total scan to help you identify any malware or viruses that might be running at startup. You can use the Tools Shortcut Manager to add shortcuts to any of these powerful programs directly to your desktop or start menu. Lastly, it also has various themes, of which my favorite is Cobalt. Hybrid Uninstaller is a great free program that does more than just uninstall programs, but also has great PC optimization tools. I highly recommend checking it out. Next up, we have WizTree, a high-speed disk space analysis utility for Windows that allows you to quickly locate and assess which files and folders are consuming the most disk space. This is done by displaying your entire hard drive's file system in a visual manner, making it incredibly easy to identify large files and folders. Utilizing the information WizTree provides can help you quickly and efficiently remove any large files from your hard drive or SSD. This can be done by either deleting the large files or moving them to an external drive or the cloud. It's very important to note that any files and folders that are required for the correct operation of your PC must not be deleted. And if you are uncertain of the purpose of a file or folder, professional IT support should be consulted. Just like with Hybrid Uninstaller, I'll be using the portable version of WizTree. Let's explore the main function of WizTree, disk space analysis. It helps us identify what's taking up space extremely fast as it reads the master file table on the selected drive. This can be done by selecting a hard drive and clicking scan. When the scan is complete, it offers a visual tree map of files and folders and finds and sorts the largest files first, so you can easily detect the biggest culprits. From here, I can find what's taking up the most space on my system. I can right-click on the file in WizTree and delete it, which will send it to the recycle bin. But I want to permanently delete it, so I'll be holding down the left shift button on the keyboard and clicking delete. I can also use the file name search function to search for a specific type of file, like .exe files, MP3s, MP4s, JPEGs, and so on. So if I know I only want to display and remove a certain file type, I can use this function to search for that type of file. By rescanning the drive, we can see we have freed up some storage space, which is what this program is all about. WizTree supports multiple file systems, such as NTFS, FAT, FAT32, and network drives. It even supports MTP and PTP devices, like smartphones and cameras, when connected via USB. So if you're constantly running out of disk space, or just want to free up some disk space on your computer and back up large unused files to another drive, be sure to give WizTree a try to make the process as effortless as possible. Before we dive into the next program, if you're interested in looking for new ways to optimize your PC or just want to stay up to date with great free software, then you need to hit the subscribe button right now. I'll be posting new videos at least once a week going forward, and if you don't want to miss out, you need to subscribe to this channel. The next program on this list is SyncBack Free. As you can see, SyncBack Free is the best free Windows backup software on the planet. SyncBack Free offers a great selection of features, including file backup and synchronization, automatic scheduling of backups, and backup file compression. It works with older versions of Windows, requires no registration to gain access, and includes a variety of helpful documentation to make it easier to use, all for free, even for commercial use. Let me show you the basics of setting it up and using it. After installing and launching the program, you'll get a prompt to visit the website for tutorials and help. You can do so if you wish, but I'll be showing you the basics in this video. Let's start by creating a new backup profile. I'll click on New and give my profile a name. Next, I'll choose what type of backup I want to use. You can click on the question mark to the left of each of them for more information, but in this tutorial, I'll be using the standard backup feature. Next, I'll choose the source and destination. You can choose to have the destination files compressed if you wish. Click OK on the prompt. Now, I will choose the source of the files I want to backup. The most common folder for most Windows users will be on the C drive, users, and then the username they are using. Here you will find your most important and frequently used folders, such as documents, pictures, music, and so on. For now, I'll go back one level to the users folder, click on my username, and click on select folder. Next, I'll choose the destination. This should be another physical drive, like an external hard drive, for example. But in this video, I'll be using a network drive. I can edit the folders I backup by clicking on Choose Subdirectories and Files. Some of the files and folders that are selected might give errors when they are trying to be copied. I recommend only the following items be selected, but if you know what you're doing, you can select whatever you want. I can also set up a schedule for the backup under the When tab, and there are a number of other features I'll find when clicking on Expert Mode, but I won't be covering that in this video. I can complete the configuration by clicking OK. It'll prompt me to do a simulated run of the profile. I always skip this and do a real backup instead. Next, to perform a backup, I'll click on the black downward facing arrow next to Run, and then I'll click on Run Unattended. Run by default will run an attended backup, which means it'll prompt me if any changes needs to be made. I suggest using the unattended method most of the time. It's important to note that files can't be backed up when they are in use, so it's best to close all programs and files on your system or even to perform a full restart on the computer before running a backup. SyncBack Free is by far the best free file backup system I have come across, and I personally use it in my business to run weekly backups on my server PC. Next, I'll demonstrate how to edit PDF files for free. LibreOffice is a powerful and free office suite similar to Microsoft Office, which also includes a word processor, spreadsheets, and presentation software. I'll be using LibreOffice Draw, which was originally designed as a sketch, diagram, and flowchart software, but is now a PDF editor in our case. You will need to download and install the whole LibreOffice suite from their website, and you can find the link down in the description. When it's done installing, open LibreOffice by clicking the icon on the desktop, then click on LibreOffice Draw. Here we have the main user interface, and before I show you how to edit PDF files, I need to explain that there will probably be two different types of PDF files that you will encounter. One being a form or document created using a computer, which is easier and faster to edit, and the other being a scanned PDF, which is basically an image file, which is harder to edit and will take longer. Let me show you how it works. First, open your PDF file by clicking on Open. Then select the PDF file you want to edit. When the file is open, you can start editing any of the text or pictures in that file. I can now change any of the text by simply clicking on it. I'll change the heading of this document. Now, if you happen to have a scanned PDF file, this is what you'll need to do. I've already opened the file I want to edit. I'll need to move the image file that's on top to the side to reveal the text underneath. As you can see, the text formatting isn't perfect, but I can edit it. Next, I'll select the text, right-click, and then click on Consolidate Text. This will fix most of the formatting issues, but you'll still have to go through the document yourself to look for any errors in the text. You can choose to add more pages to your document before exporting, but if you're done, the fastest way to export the edited PDF file is to click on Export directly as PDF. If you want some more options, like signing the file with a watermark or setting a password on the document, you can go to File, Export As, then Export as PDF, and you'll find those settings and a few others on this page. If you want to save it in another format, you can go to File, Export, and you will see a bunch of other file formats in the drop-down menu. If you're looking for a great free PDF editor with a lot of functionality, then you definitely need to give LibreOffice Draw a try. The last program is called ShareX, an extremely powerful screen capture, file sharing, and productivity tool. This small piece of software is packed with a variety of different features, is completely free and open source, has no ads, and has been in development for over 15 years. It features a wide variety of screen capture methods with different regions you can select and different tasks and edits you can perform after capturing your screen, such as editing the screenshot in different ways and uploading it directly to Imgur. There are also a few powerful productivity tools such as a color picker, image editor, video converter, and QR code generator. After downloading and installing ShareX, the program will open to a really simple UI, and you'll see a window with different options and the most basic hotkeys that are preset. If you wish to change these hotkeys, you can do so in the Hotkey Settings tab and even add new hotkeys. Let's take a look at some of the most useful features. First, the obvious. Screenshots. By clicking on Capture, we can see the different modes, such as full screen, window, monitor, and region. Region is essentially a drawing mode that lets you choose exactly what you want to capture on screen. Next is screen recording. It's a good alternative to OBS Studio if you just want to record short clips. If you're interested in using ShareX to record your screen, I advise you to go to Task Settings, Screen Recorder, and Screen Recording Options. Once you make it here and you don't see all the advanced options, I recommend clicking on Install Recorder Devices. This will ensure you have more options to choose from among different videos and audio codecs. Another great feature is the OCR feature, where you can select any text on the screen, even in a picture, and it'll be converted into text which you can copy and edit. ShareX has a load of other features which I can't cover in this video, but the most notable are the screen color picker, video converter, QR code creator, and different upload tasks you can perform after capture, like uploading the image to Imgur. A quick tip here, if you accidentally upload a file to Imgur, you can delete it by right-clicking on the file in ShareX, going to Open, and clicking on the deletion URL. You will be directed to the Imgur website and have the option to permanently delete the file. Out of all the software I covered in this video, ShareX has to be my favorite. Which one was yours? Let me know in the comments below, and if you're looking for more great free software, watch the video on screen now and I'll see you there. You can go ahead and click into the video on screen now.